What is going on, guys? It's the Mad Dragon. We are slowly getting near to Christmas, so what better than a bit of rugby news as an early Christmas gift for everyone? So, last week we did a couple videos about Rugby 22. The first one about where is it? Why is it not coming? And the second one about it's here, it's coming. Because they answered to that video very, very quickly. We got to see some really early shots of the game now. We've been able to actually pre-order it if people want to. It's on the game website. I'll put the link to that video down in the description. That way, if people want to go check out all of that stuff, they can go check out that video, because we went through quite a lot about Rugby 22 in that video. We've had some further updates, which is really fun to talk about. So we've got a new game case that's come out. Whether it's going to be fully official or not is up for grabs. We've got some more images from the game that have come out, as well as a list of achievements that's going to be available to get in the game. Now, a lot of people are going to be thinking, oh, I don't really care about achievements, but that actually reveals quite a lot about the game just by reading what the achievements actually ask you to do. So let's begin with the game case. So here it is on screen for you guys to check out. So this is the first sort of real image we've had of Rugby 22 now actually having a case out. Now, I actually saw this case for the first time on a site called GameBite.com. Now, that's not a site I know a lot about. I'm not sure how reputable that source is. But as you can see here, they did have this case. I've only got the Xbox One on screen. They did also have it in PlayStation and PS5, PS4 and all that. They did have it on, and it was the same for all cases. So what we got here, Rugby 22, their design logos they've had for the game already, and three players in the front. Normally we saw in Rugby 20 they only had one player. This time they've gone for three. I'm not the greatest with just players by faces, but I can see that we've got Antoine Dupont on the far left there. Obviously a lot of people call him, you know, one of the best players in the world now. He probably deserves to be on that box. Player at the front has got is it a Toulon player? Oh, it might be Cheslin Colby. I'm always used to Cheslin Colby with his scrum cap on. It does look like Cheslin Colby. I think Cheslin Colby plays for Toulon as well. So I think that's probably Cheslin Colby. And the final player on the right, I'm not great with rugby player faces. I don't know who that is. It's a yellow kit. The other two are from top 14 clubs, like French clubs. So I imagine it's yellow. Who plays in yellow? Like Clermont, I think Clermont playing yellow. I don't know a great deal of the French league roster. I can't pick that guy out by his face alone. I'm not very good at that. I'm much better with names on a piece of paper of who I know who I'm talking about. So apologies for that one. I'm sure some people will know in the comments down who that is and can drop down. So just to let us all know who that actually is on the front cover on the right hand side. But this is the first image. It's not the most grasping of box covers. It is just three players on a front cover. It's a bit bland. The background symbol, red and white. We've not seen that color scheme anywhere in the game in terms of the menu system from what we've seen in the early pictures. It is a bit more resembling of the actual title logo, I guess you could say. But other than that, nothing really particular to point out there. An interesting point for this one is I did actually notice on this site, this GameBite website, that the game is up at £28.95. Now, like I said, don't know how reputable that source is. I'm not claiming people should go buy from this site, shouldn't pre-order from this site, because I'm not 100% sure how official it all is. I've never ordered anything from them but myself, so I don't know a lot about them. But that's like a £15 discount on a game that isn't even out yet compared to what we've seen on the game pre-order that we did in the last video. So if you want a cheaper game, there could be potential for this game to start hemorrhaging in price if places have already got it listed for sub £30. But we'll see what gets on. But let me know what you guys think of the case down in the comments. Bearing that in mind, we'll now move on to talk about some of the new images that we've seen from the game. So this, I actually came when I saw it on game, we did the original images from the game that we'd seen so far. Now we've gone on, I did say in that video, I could see it for Xbox and PlayStation on pre-order, not on PC. Why could I not see it on PC? Well, that's because it's coming straight out on Steam. So we can check it out on Steam here. And as you can see on the right-hand side here, there is that same image as we just saw on the GameBite website. We've got the same three players, the same background, the same logo. And this is on Steam, probably a much more reputable site. So it's looking like this could well be the box cover for the game. So that's interesting to see. So we can see a bit of cohesion there, which is always nice when you've got these sort of below the radar games in a bit of a grey area, difficult to see. So what we'll do is we'll have a quick look through some of the images that we've come across. So let's start out with this one here. This one here is looking like they're setting up for a drop goal. Now, I believe the kit in the blue kit anyway seems to be very similar to what we saw in the original images of the lineouts. That white team, like we said in the old video, doesn't look like that there's any sort of particular logo or sponsor on this. This looks like it's creator team, potentially. Maybe this is that they just didn't want to give away who they've got licenses for already. Or maybe they're actually just looking to show off that maybe you can do creator team, you can do two creator teams. Maybe this is a multiplayer, two creator teams playing against each other. Always interesting. The stadium doesn't resemble anything that like jumps off straight at the top of my head in terms of Rugby 20. I've no doubt they're probably going to use a lot of the similar assets, but like we said in the other video, a lot of the graphics still looking very similar to what we saw in Rugby 20. Now we've got a second image here. This is of a scrum. Again, we've got this sort of blue team. There's a slightly different blue kit this time around. It's like a half and half blue kit now. We've also got a team all in red, looks like, I don't know, maybe a fake Wales kit or something. Interesting that the numbers on the shirts are also the same colour as the shirt, rather than anything defining. You can barely see that number 6 shirt on the player in the flanker position there. With the point of interesting note here is that on this screen, considering this is a scrum currently engaged, I cannot see the defensive scrum half, nor the referee in this picture. Now, this is interesting because obviously if you'll ever watch a game of rugby, you'll normally see probably both the scrum halves competing, fighting to get round the back, try and get a position. A bit more difficult to do that in a game, that's granted, that's fine. But interesting to not see a ref next to the scrum. So wonder if they're going to have a ref in this game. Maybe they're not going to have an on-field ref. I quite like it when there's a ref actually on the field, but maybe they won't do that. And then finally, we've got the final image, which is this lineout, which I don't think we covered in the last video. But as you can see here, the ball coming in, this is a pretty standard lineout, much more of a dark blue team, the same yellow and white kit that we've seen now a couple of times. So there is looking like they're doing a lot of this creator team. They obviously not wanting to release who they've got as the licensed teams, even though they've already said they've got over 60 teams confirmed licensed. They just haven't revealed who a lot of them are. So I'm not sure why they're not showing off some of the actual international teams or someone they've got, but at least we can see a bit more of the game. But in terms of the actual imagery, this to me is looking a lot like Rugby 20. I'm not seeing anything in particular here that really jumps out to me as vast improvements. The players sort of look the same. The way they're standing sort of looks the same. The grass texture looks the same. The way the crowd is the same. It could even be the same stadium. So not a lot of new news to go on there really. So unfortunately that's what we'll take away from that one. And then finally, we have a list of achievements. Now, like I said, a lot of people won't be bothered about gamer score or trophies or what have you. But the thing that I found really interesting about this list is the fact that some of these achievements actually reveal what's going to be happening in the game and certain mechanics and stuff. So I find that stuff really quite interesting. So there are 37 achievements in total. So what we'll do, we'll quickly run through the more generic ones, but we'll point out some of the more interesting ones. So I'll chuck them all on screen for you guys now. This will be part one because I can't fit them all on one screen at one time. So starting off at the top, on top of the world, win the World Cup. So the World Cup is officially in. They're not calling it anything else. They're not calling it the World Series or World Tour or anything. They have called it the World Cup. That's nice to see. Win the top 14. So the top 14 is there. Be a bit strange to have all the French league players on the box cover art if you're not going to have the top 14 in there. Absolutely fine. Fighting Spirit, win the United Rugby Championship. So that's of course now replaced the Pro 14s that they will have had in Rugby 20. So that's pretty standard. We expected that. Promotion, win the Pro D2, which is, I thought it used to be the Pro 12s? No, I've got confused. There's too many leagues to keep track of in this game. That'll be more towards like the English leagues and stuff, I believe. Anyway, that's what they tend to lean towards rather than call it like the English Premiership or what have you. Alive and King, win a match by taking the lead with a drop kick in the last 10 minutes. That's perfectly fine. So they are going to keep that drop goal system in. Finish a match without committing a foul. So, you know, that's normally quite easy in these games unless they've really upped the difficulty in this game. Who knows? Win a match without scoring a try. Win a match by trailing by 14 points. Score a try with a set play, so they're keeping the set plays in. Hopefully they come up with some new set plays, that would be interesting to see. Score a try in the first 10 minutes of the match, that tends to be what we see from England now, they love that early try ongoing there. Score a try after the siren sound. So they're going to be adding in that siren that we've heard so much now in like of actual rugby, live rugby. We saw a lot, especially in the Southern Hemisphere tours, the first place I've really seen it when we went off with the Lions. The Southern Hemisphere like to have that siren alert. We saw it in the Super Rugby Aotearoa as well. That's becoming a thing that tends to be after the 80-minute whistle. Not sure if they'll do one after the 40-minute whistle. There's like a mini siren, but the 80-minute whistle is definitely where they have that final siren. So basically score a try in extra time. But nice to know they're adding in a siren sound. Score a try after a grubber kick, perfectly fine. I hope they actually refine that grubber kick system a bit. It was really easy to do a grubber kick, but what I really struggled to do in Rugby 20 was the second grubber kick, to keep kicking it onwards. Rugby 2011, the World Cup game, had that absolutely down. That mechanic was perfect. In Rugby 20, it was like impossible to actually keep kicking the ball on and have players run after, which was a bit of a shame. Catch all the line-out throws during a match. That can be a bit tricky. Sometimes you can lose them. Kick the ball outside the 22-meter line from within the goal area. So that's just sort of clearing your lines. Perform a turnover in a ruck at least 5 meters from the goal line. Okay, so that's a nice little attacking. Doesn't say whether that's attacking or defensive. Is that to turn over the ball to stop you conceding a try or to help you score a try? Don't know which way around, and maybe it'll apply to both 5 meter lines. Move up a division in career mode, so the career mode's still going to be going on. Nice to see that. Fully upgrade the staff in career mode, we saw that in the last one, and then reach an elite division in career mode. So again, we saw that in Rugby 20. On to the second set of achievements to fit them all on one screen. Investing in the future, buy a player, so we can buy, hopefully sell players, buying and selling players. I hope they've changed the trading system of players a bit more in that career mode. I would like that to be a bit more in depth than every 4 weeks one random player appears that you can buy for an outrageous cost that you could never really afford in the career mode. Definitely needed a bit of switching there. Train a player in career mode, perfectly fine. Finish the season as the top point scorer, never a difficulty in Rugby 20, was far too easy in that game. Win all the scrums in a match. Invest in a friendly match. Now, I don't know whether that's just the wording of this one. This one to me maybe appears to be sort of similar to what we saw in Rugby 20, where they had friendly games that you could take on. It reduced your player's stamina, but you actually earned in-game currency for the career mode. So maybe that's just what that means by invest in a friendly match. Maybe it means, I don't even know what else it can mean, really. Maybe you challenge another team. Maybe you put up almost like a bet, or you pick which team you want to play and you earn a certain amount of income depending on the difficulty of the team you play as a friendly. Maybe you get to take a bit more of a management role. That could be fun. Let's see what they do with that one. Sacrifice. Fuse a card. Now, we saw the card system for a lot of the rugby players in Rugby 20. They all had different cards. You got them from packs and stuff. Fuse a card. Now, what will that mean? That one opens up an awful lot of avenues. Is it going to be, I can't imagine combining players. That's a bit too much Digimon for me to believe they're going to combine players. But maybe stuff to do with combine a player with a certain like fitness card. Maybe something to increase their kicking or their passing or their tackling. Maybe it's going to be like we had the bonus cards in Rugby 20, but instead of applying it to the team generally, you apply it to an individual player to help some of their stats. Maybe you help them get over an injury. Maybe if a player now gets injured within a game, they're going to be out for 5-6 weeks in career mode. Fuse them with a medical or a physio card. Maybe you allow them to fix. I think that's interesting. Really looking forward to see where they go with that one. Complete a team training session with a perfect score. So again, just doing some training stuff. I tend to do quite a lot of the training in the game because I like to have quite a big career-based team. And finally, completionist. Complete one grid of missions. Now, missions in Rugby 20 were quite poor. They didn't really work. Like, if they came up, they did, but it would be like score one try, then score one conversion, then score one penalty, and you did it in two games. There was no challenge to it. These are things that just happen in a game anyway. Hopefully when they say a grid of missions, hopefully they're quite intricate things. You know, score a try 3 phases from a set play, or maybe score 5 tries in a game. Hit the post or the crossbar during a conversion. I think that sort of thing would be really interesting. But there we have it, guys. That's going to be the update for today. So we've got some new box art. We've got a bunch of achievements that we can now look through and sort of try and dictate what we think might come out in the game in terms of mechanics and stuff. And also we've got a few more images of the game. They don't really display a lot. I just thought you guys might enjoy seeing some new images of the game. Of course, we will be picking this game up when it comes out in January. We'll be playing a bunch of it. We'll be doing some reviews. I might even do some live streams on it, which is one thing I'm really looking forward to. So to keep up to date with all those videos as they come out, make sure you subscribe to the channel just to keep up to date with when those videos are released. And if you've enjoyed this one and enjoyed the news and the update about this sort of video, I feel like I'm doing a lot of gaming news recently. There's so many games to talk about that I'm enjoying. Rugby, Alan Wake, I'm enjoying all of it. But if you've enjoyed this one, make sure you drop it a like. But I hope you've all enjoyed this one today, guys. I will see you in the future, hopefully for some more Rugby 22 news when we have some more updates about the game. I'll see you all next time, guys. Bye-bye.